I'm Wanoco, a 3D artist. In this video, I will show you how I usually make 3D animations. Second, some rules for creating animations. Third, make the animation in detail. In 3D animation is to try to make the video uncut and long take as much as possible. The montage technique is often used in actual movies. This is a technique to compose a scene with multiple cuts. Montages are wonderful, but one of the reasons they are used is the difficulty of creating full-length uncut video in real-life shoot. Even in 3D, long take footage is more difficult than montage, but it's not as hard as shooting videos in real life. Long running videos are immersive and exciting. Here I will create an animation of the vehicle. First and foremost, determine the speed of the plane at around Mach 1. It looks like a real fighter jet. Once the speed is determined, the size of the background required for the scene is also determined. First, let's put the event in order. This is the same as the storyboard stage. At this time, it is not important to put keyframes in detail. First, an aircraft comes from afar and passes in front of you. Then, it makes a U-turn, passes in front of you at a tremendous speed again, and fly away. For refining the animation, set the dominant lighting in the 3D environment. Here I put a sunlight. Since the scene will be rendered in the end, I would like to improve the compatibility between animation and lighting. Of course, you can make animation while rendering in real time in EV. At this early stage, you will be able to find nice combination of lighting and animation out of an infinite number of possible scenes. Background as one large visual element in the scene. I think position of sun image doesn't have to match the lighting perfectly. Match only the approximate direction and find the position as one object. This will be a clue for exploring both lighting and camera work. Move the aircraft in this 3D space. However, a policy of emulating reality often helps you to create cool video. This time, I want to make an acrobatic video, so videos of fighter jet and games of dogfight are good reference. Airplanes are controlled by roll, pitch, and yaw. And it's the pitch that is dominant in intense flight. And roll is used to guide the direction of the pitch. You can feel this by piloting an airplane in the game. The camera can move freely in 3D too. However, I dare to make animation as if the camera is held in reality. Imagine a camera that has mass and obeys the law of physics. Because many movies in the world are shot with real heavy camera like that, and we are used to seeing that camera work. Unrealistic camera animation can be very difficult to make acceptable. In camera animation, I consider the most basic physics. It's a law of inertia. This law states that the greater the mass, the harder it is to move. And since the camera is somewhat heavy, it is difficult to move it suddenly. In order to satisfy this law, I sometimes allow the subject to be out of the frame. Also, to create long taken videos with smooth camera work, the movement of the camera is complicated and difficult to make. So it is essential to search for animation in the 3D viewport instead of storyboards. especially in slow motion, it can be said that the law of physics have a strong influence on the operation of the camera. All objects will move almost linearly. Therefore, in order to indirectly design the animation of the camera during slow motion, it is necessary to make preliminary movement before slow motion. Nodes. Geometry nodes objects are relatively simple 3D asset for effects, so there is no need to simulate and bake them. Thanks to that, you can change the start time, place the effect, adjust the parameter and see what it looks like in real time. The appearance of the vapor effect on the aircraft depends on the movement of the vehicle. Dynamic effects like this are difficult with geometry nodes, so I use particle system. By putting keyframe on object position, rotation, etc. in your animation, you can add automatic movement to that variable. As I mentioned in my old video, animation has modifier too. There is a noise modifier that allows you to automatically add camera shake. The frequency of camera movement is, in principle, different for each variable. The state of each vibration can also be determined by imagining the physics of camera. In many cases, the camera has a downward force of gravity on it and a repulsive force on it. Therefore, vertical vibrations are likely to be severe. On the other hand, keeping the camera level requires control. For humans, it would be difficult to keep horizontal all the time. With that in mind, we can say that the Y rotation has slow noise added to it. Also, editing animation with modifier has interesting results. It's a complex movement within one frame. You won't see this effect in the viewport, but you can see it if you render with motion blur enabled. This effect is difficult to obtain with keyframing alone, so it can be said that it is a result unique to the modifiers. It usually takes a heavy rendering load to get motion blur like this, but if you have a powerful GPU, you should be fine. Complex motion blur like this is probably closer to reality than linearly interpolated CGI, and I am simply fascinated by such chaos of systems. Add some light to make the rendered result look better. Since animation requires continuous images, lighting position cannot be determined by evaluating only one frame. You actually have to render different scenes and figure out lighting settings that look reasonably good all the time. It can be said that the rendering speed strongly affects feedback speed and the quality of the work. Add cloud as 3D environment design. Recently, I've been placing clouds with image textures. Some time ago, I used to render cloud as 3D object with meshes and procedural materials. However, designing cloud is elusive and lighting consideration will be more complicated. Finished image of the cloud, which looks nice. At this point, the experience of trial and error while rendering cloud before it comes into play. Here, I can roughly imagine the relationship between sunlight and how the clouds are illuminated, so I can place clouds that match the lighting environment to some extent. Fine-tune the camera work before finalizing the animation. At this time, enable composition guides. Guiding line related to standard composition such as the rule of thirds and golden ratio are available. and if you enable them, you may notice a hidden valid screen layout. Again, rather than looking at the line of the 3D object in solid view, it's better to render it and see the light and shade of each area. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you haven't already, please subscribe to the YouTube channel and stay tuned for new videos.